Hello friends, the TCP provides congestion control mechanism. So let us discuss how this congestion control is achieved in TCP. Now let us discuss more about congestion. So now let us start with the congestion control. What do you mean by a congestion control? It is a mechanism or a technique to keep the load below the capacity. So every network has a particular capacity. For example, the one network is having the capacity of processing 200 packets and you are sending the 300 packet to on that network. So whether it is able to process, so means you are giving the load of 300 packet and the network capacity is a 200 packet. So in that case, there is a chances of congestion because you are providing more load as compared to that of network capacity. So now let us discuss about the different topic. The first is a network performance. Your congestion control, of course, it affects the network performance. We'll discuss about it. Next is a congestion control mechanism. So what are the technique with the help of that we can achieve the congestion control? Next is a congestion control in TCP. So how the congestion control is achieved in the TCP, we'll discuss about it. Now let us discuss about what you mean by a congestion. The load on the network is greater than the capacity of network. So just now we discussed your load should be less than that of network capacity. If it is more, then the congestion will occur. The congestion happens in any system that involves the vetting. Basically, as you know, whenever any packet reaches to the router, there will be some time taken by the router to process that data. So here the waiting time will be there. So whenever the system is having waiting time, there will be a congestion. Now let us discuss why the congestion is there in the network. An internet is a combination of networks and the connecting device. As you know, the network is nothing but what? Interconnected device, interconnected network. So this device can be your router or can be your switches. A router has a buffer that stores the incoming packet and process them and forward them. So just now we discussed, so whenever any packet comes to the router, what the router will do? It will store that in the buffer, it will process it, and then it will forward to the next path. Now let us discuss when there is a chances of congestion. The first point, the input queue must be congested. Now, when there will be a congestion at the input side, the packet arrival rate is greater than that of packet processing rate. Now, see here, for example, the router. Router is having the buffer and you are giving more number of packet, but the processing speed of router is less. Then what will happen? The packets are goes on accumulating in the buffer. So here in this case, your packet rate is greater than that of processing rate. So of course, the congestion will occur in this case. Let us discuss when the congestion will occur at the output queue. The output queue may be congested when the packet departure rate is less than packet processing rate. Same here, for the processing, you need a more time. So because of that, the packet departure rate will be less. So in that case also, the congestion will occur. Now let us discuss about, this is a router. And in the router, can you see there are input and the output queue? So whenever the packet comes to the router, the where it will store, the first it will store into the input buffer. And then the router take out that packet from the buffer, process it, see the what is a routing table, and then it will put into the outgoing queue. So of course, for that, all this processing needs some more time. So first, When the packet arrives at the incoming interface, it undergoes the three steps before departing. So whenever any packet comes to the router, there are three steps it has to follow. Let us discuss about the first step. The packet is placed at the end of input queue while waiting to be checked. The always your packet first, it is put into the input queue and then it will wait for its turn. The processing module of the router removes the packet from the incoming queue. Once it has reached in front of the queue, use its routing table destination address to find the route. So now what my router will do, the router will take out that packet when that packet turns will come. And then it will process it. Process it means what? It will find out, it will check the routing table and then decide at what destination route he has to send. And then according to that, it will send it into the output queue. The packet is put into the appropriate output queue and wait its turn to send. So once it find out from the table, that is routing table, what is the position of the router, according to that, it will put into the outgoing queue. Now, basically, what do you mean by a network performance? We'll discuss about that. And your network performance depend upon what factor, we'll discuss about it. A congestion control involves two factors that measure the network performance. So basically your network performance, of course, it is get affected by the congestion. Now it will affect on what factor? The first factor is a delay and the second factor is throughput. Now let us discuss delay versus load. Now we goes on varying the load and find out how it will affect the delay. So when the load is small, delay is minimum. For example, you are sending the packet less. Of course, my router will require less time to process it. So whenever load is less, that time your delay is minimum. Now let us discuss your delay is depend upon what factor. A delay is nothing but a propagation delay plus processing delay. Means how much time it required to transfer from source to destination, and plus the processing delay means how much each device required to process it. So that delay is also added. So both of them can be negligible. So whenever you are sending the less number of packet at that time, this delay will be the negligible. When the load is become larger, now you goes on sending more number of packets. The delay, that is propagation delay, processing delay, and waiting time in all router queue along the path. So just now we discussed, whenever any packet comes to the router, it has to follow the three steps. And for the three steps, it needs some time. And then it will forward that packet. So whenever there is large number of load, at that time this waiting time will increases, and because of that your delay will increase. So when the load is greater, the capacity, now when this will happen, whenever you are sending more number of packet than the capacity of the network, so in that case you will get infinite delay. Now see here, this is a graph, that is delay versus load. Now see here, in this case my delay was less. So what happened to the congestion? The congestion was also less. As your capacity or load goes on increasing, your delay is also goes on increasing. Whenever the load was less, at that time the delay was less. But here, now can you see here, the delay is goes on increasing. In that case, you can see here, your delay is also goes on increasing. So as the load increases, delay increases because of the waiting time. Now the delay has a negative effect on the load and congestion. So basically delay will give us a negative effect. What is that negative effect? Let us discuss about it. When the packet is delayed or dropped in the router, so as you know, due to congestion, what will happen? Your packet get delayed or it may discarded by the router. So no acknowledgement is received by the sender. So when these packets are dropped, the acknowledgement will not reach to the sender. Then sender, what he will think? That the packet didn't reach to the receiver and he will retransmit that packet. The sender will retransmit the packet, create more congestion and more delaying and dropping of the packet. So here, when the router keep on discarding the packet, the sender will keep on retransmitting that packets. And because of that, the overall congestion will goes on increasing. Now let us discuss the next factor, that is a throughput. So we'll discuss, compare the throughput with versus the load. So let us discuss what you mean by a throughput. Throughput means the number of packet passing through the network in unit time. How many numbers of packets are passing through the network, that is called as a throughput. If more number of packets are passing through the network, more will be the throughput. If less number of packets are passing through the network, means it is a less throughput. So when the load is below the capacity of the network, so in the first case, what we are considering? We are considering now our load is less than that of capacity. Throughput increases proportionally with the load. So now whenever the load is below the capacity, at that time your throughput is goes on increasing. When the load reach the capacity, but whenever your load is reached to capacity. Now see here in this diagram. See now initially whenever the load was less than capacity, your throughput was goes on increasing. But at this point when it reached to the capacity, means your load is equal to that of capacity. Can you see here? The throughput is goes on decreasing. So throughput declines sharply. Since the more segments are discarded by the router, so now here the more number of packets are sent to the network and that is beyond the capacity of the network. So of course the network will discard that packets. And due to the discarding, what will happen? The retransmission of the packet by the sender. And due to that, the more number of segments are sent to the router. And however, discard segment caused the more segment to be transmitted. So the TCP uses retransmission scheme. So means what? Whenever any packet didn't reach to the receiver or whenever the sender didn't get the acknowledgement, he will retransmit the packet. So that is called as a retransmission scheme. So whenever the sender didn't get the acknowledgement, what it will think that packet didn't reach to the receiver and he will retransmit the segment. So because of that, the more segments are sent to the network. So here, whenever my load was less, at that time throughput was increasing. When it reached to the capacity, means my load is equal to the capacity, my throughput is goes on decreasing because of congestion, because lot many packets are discarded, and because of that my throughput decreases. Now we discussed about what you mean by the congestion. Now let us focus on how to avoid this congestion. So for that, we use a congestion control mechanism to avoid the congestion. Congestion control to prevent the congestion before it happens. So by the two way, we can avoid the congestion. Prevent the congestion before it happened. Or the second case, to remove the congestion after it happens. So first, we have to take care that congestion should not take place. And if it is take place, the second technique say that how to overcome that congestion. So there are two categories. The first is open loop congestion control, means that to avoid the congestion, that we'll study over here. The second is closed loop congestion, means when the congestion is take place, at that time how to overcome it. Now let us discuss about open loop congestion control. Prevent the congestion before it happens. Just now we discuss in the open loop, we'll see how to avoid the congestion. Possible policies. The first is a retransmission policy. The retransmission policy and the retransmission timer should be designed to optimize efficiency. Now, how it is achieved? So basically, we have to look after retransmission policy. Retransmission policy means whenever the acknowledgement didn't get to the receiver, receiver will retransmit it. The second is a retransmission timer. So whenever he didn't get the acknowledgement within the particular time span, the sender again retransmitted. So you have to consider or you have to design the policy in such a way that you will optimize the efficiency of the network. Next, we have to focus on the acknowledgement policy. Does not acknowledge every packet it receives. When the sender send the first packet, receiver will give the acknowledgement, then my sender will send the second packet, then my receiver will give the third acknowledgement. So here the acknowledgement for the every packet, so because of that more number of segment you need to send. Instead of that, what we can do? Instead of that, cumulative acknowledgement, that is a one concept, you know. Here we are giving the acknowledgement of combined packets. It does not slow down the sender and helps to prevent the congestion. So in the cumulative, what will happen? You need to send the less number of segment. So because of less number of segments sent on the network, of course the congestion will be less. Router should adopt a good discard policy. So in the, for example, the congestion happens at that time, the which packet to be discarded. So for that also, the good policy should be implemented. Now let us discuss about the closed loop congestion control. So here we're going to remove the congestion. Now the congestion after it happens. Now this, with the help of this policy, we're going to remove the congestion after it happens. So the possible mechanism is a back pressure. What do you mean by a back pressure? When the router is congested, it can inform the previous unstream router to reduce the rate of outgoing packets. So router which is behind that router, who is sending the data, for example, this is A and this is B. For example, the congestion occur at the router B. So it should inform the router A that please reduce the speed of packet. So the action can be recursive all the way to the router just prior to the source. So we are informing the behind router to reduce the packet rate, and because of that the congestion control will take place. Next point is a choke point. A router send the packet to the source to inform the congestion. Whenever congestion happens, that router should inform the source that congestion is occur, please drop out the rate. This packet is called as choke point, like ICMP source quench packet. So basically here, whenever the congestion occurs at the router, it should inform to the source so that source will reduce the number of packet. Because of that, congestion control will take place. Now next is implicit signaling. source can detect an implicit signal warning of congestion. Now source can come to know is there is congestion in the network by what method. For example, delay in receiving the acknowledgement. So whenever sender understand that he didn't get acknowledgement immediately, means of course there is a congestion in the network. So that is called as implicit signaling. Now let us discuss about explicit signaling. The router can send an explicit signal to the sender or receiver of congestion. For example, set a bit in the packet. Here the congestion information is sent to the source or receiver. By setting the control bit, he can inform the source or receiver that congestion is occur in the network. Now let us discuss about congestion control in TCP. So first we'll discuss about the congestion window. Second, we'll discuss about the congestion policy. The first is slow start. Second is congestion avoidance. And third technique is a congestion detection. Now let us discuss about the congestion window. Flow control. What do you mean by flow control? Matching the speed of sender as well as receiver. If any of one speed is more or less, what will happen? Its buffer will overflow, and because of that the packets are discarded and your information will not reach to the destination. So for that the flow control mechanism play a very important role. A sender window size is determined by available buffer space in the receiver. So as you know, the TCP uses sliding window protocol. So here your window size, how it is determined, how much buffer space is available, according to that it will define the window size. However, in addition to receiver, the window should be a second entity that determines the size of sender window. So basically, along with the buffer size, there is one more entity which play an important role in the flow control. The congestion control determines the sender window size by congestion condition in the network. So next factor, that is first factor, is depending upon the space in the buffer. Next factor is how much congestion in the network. That also play a very important role whenever he is setting the window size. Thus, the sender window size is determined by both receiver and congestion in the network. So basically, this window size is determined by receiver and the second factor, that is a congestion in the network. The sender has two pieces of information. The receiver advertised window size and second is a congestion window size. So basically there are two window size. The first one is the receiver window size and the second is congestion window size. So the actual size of window is minimum of these two. So in the sliding window protocol, we discuss about the actual window size will be the minimum of whether it is a receiving window size or the congestion window size. Who is having the minimum value, we consider that value. So my actual window size is nothing but minimum of receiver window size and the congestion window size. For example, my congestion window is 10 and my receiving window is 20. So my window size will consider that is 10. Minimum between these two value, we consider that as a window size. Now let us discuss about the congestion policies. Three phase in the TCP congestion policy. So basically it follow the three important policies to avoid the congestion. The first, it will start with slow start. Then it move to the congestion avoidance. And the third step is a congestion detection. When the congestion is detected, the sender will return to slow start or the congestion avoidance method. So whenever he detects the congestion, it will move to the slow start or it will move to the congestion avoidance. When it will move to the slow start and when it will move to the congestion avoidance, let us discuss about that. Now let us discuss about the slow start. Slow start, exponential increase. What do you mean by the exponential increase? We discuss about that. At the beginning, the congestion window size is a maximum segment size. So here in the slow start, we set our congestion window size to the maximum segment size, means how many number of segment you are sending. Your window size will set to that value. MSS is determined during the connection establishment using the option. This is determined during the connection establishment. For each segment that is acknowledged, increase the congestion size by one maximum segment unit. For example, you consider the window size. For example, it is 1. And whenever you got the next acknowledgement, you will increase the window size. When you get the third acknowledgement, again you increase the window size until it reach to the threshold. So when, until what I should increase the window size? That is when your window size will reach to the threshold. This threshold is also called as SS thresh. That is nothing but slow start threshold. Usually, slow start threshold is 65,535 bytes. When the size of window reach to this threshold, slow start stop and the next phase will start. So whenever your window size reach to this threshold, your slow start phase will stop and it will move to the next phase. Let us discuss how the window size increases exponentially. However, it is not actually a slow start. The congestion window size increases exponentially. For example, we consider start at the starting end, your window size is 1. 1 means what? 2 raised to 0. That is nothing but 1. Once I get the first acknowledgement, my window size is increased by 2 raised to 1. Once you got the second acknowledgement, 2 raised to 1 is nothing but 2. Once you got the second acknowledgement, your window size increases to 2 raised to 2, that is nothing but 4. When you got the third acknowledgement, your window size raised to 2 raised to 3, that is nothing but 8. So here the window size increases exponentially. Now let us discuss this example. Now see here, this is my sender, this is my receiver. My sender having the window size 1. So he sent the packet when he got the first acknowledgement. So it window size is become 2 raised to 1. That is nothing but 2. When he got the second acknowledgement, so my window size 2 raised to 2. That is nothing but 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. When he got the third acknowledgement, the window size become 2 raised to 3. That is nothing but 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the window size will goes on increasing once the acknowledgement is received. So this is called as an exponentially increase in the window size. Now let us start with the congestion avoidance technique, that is nothing but additive increase. Start after the congestion window size reach the threshold value. Now, just now we discussed, whenever my window size reached through the threshold value, what will happen? Slow start phase will stop and it will move to the next phase, that is nothing but additive increase phase. When the whole window of segment is acknowledged, now in the additive increase, what will happen when the whole segment, whole window of the segment is acknowledged? That time only the window size will increase. In the previous case, when I got the next acknowledgement, at that time the window size is increased. But over here, whenever the whole window segment is acknowledged, at that time the window size is increased. Note that the whole window size is actually larger than one in the congestion avoidance. Now see here, this is my sender, this is my receiver. The first window size was 1. When he got the acknowledgement, window sizes become 2. When he got the third acknowledgement, window sizes become 3. When he got the fourth acknowledgement, the window sizes become 4. So here your window size is increased by 1. But in the previous case, it was increasing exponentially. So here, initially, my window size was 1. When he got the first acknowledgement, window size become 2. When he got the second acknowledgement, window size become 3. When he got third acknowledgement, the window sizes become 4. Now let us discuss about the next policy, that is a congestion detection multiplicative decrease. If the congestion occur, the congestion window size must be decreased. Now in the previous case, there was no congestion. But now what we consider here, the congestion occur. When the congestion occur, you need to reduce your window size. How to detect the congestion? Now the next question arises, how to detect the congestion? The need to retransmit the segment. The first point is how the sender come to know there is a congestion whenever he need to retransmit the segment. Means what? He need to retransmit the segment means what? He is not getting acknowledgement. Means that packet may be dropping somewhere. When to retransmit the segment? When an RTO timer is out and when the 3 duplicated acknowledgement is received. So as you know, my sender will send the packet in the 2 case. When the RTO timer is mature. For example, whenever sender is sending any segment, he will start the RTO timer. And then before that timer finish, your acknowledgement should reach to the sender. Otherwise, my sender will retransmit that packet. So whenever this timer is mature, means get over, my sender will retransmit it. In the second case, when the retransmission is done, whenever he got the 3 continuous acknowledgement for that packet, the sender will immediately send the packet. In both the cases, the size of threshold is half of the current congestion window size. Here in this case, your window size is reduces to half of the current congestion window size. So it is called as multiplicative decrease. However, different actions are taken. So basically, we have the 2 cases. Whenever the timer is time out, at that time the retransmission is done. The second is when he got the 3 acknowledgement. So both the cases are handled by the separate way. If the timeout occur, strongly possibility of the congestion. So whenever your RTO timer is getting mature and you are not getting the acknowledgement, my sender need to retransmit, means it is a strong possibility that there is a congestion in the network. So in that case, your threshold should be set to the half of the current congestion window. So as you know, here the threshold is nothing but half of the current congestion window size. So this is called as multiplicative decrease. The congestion window should start from the one again. So here, now your congestion window will considered as one and it will start the process. Sender will return to slow start phase. So what it will do? It will set the window size to one and then it will start the slow start phase. Whenever there is a timeout occurs. Now the second case, that is three acknowledgement for a particular packet. At that time also my sender will send or retransmit that packet. Now how to handle this situation? If three duplicate acknowledgement is received, a weaker possibility of congestion. So you are getting three acknowledgement. So it is a weaker possibility that congestion is there in the network. A segment may have dropped, but some segment after that may arrive safely since the acknowledgement is received. So I am getting the three acknowledgement means what? That there is a little bit congestion in the network, that segment is may drop somewhere, and now that congestion is overcome, and because of that only, I am able to receive the three acknowledgement. Invoke the fast retransmission and fast recovery. In this case, the TCP has a weaker reaction as below. In the previous case, it is taking a strong action, but over here, it is taking a weak action. A threshold should be set to the half of current congestion window size. As usual, in the previous case, here also, my threshold is set to the half of current congestion window size. And here the multiplicative decrease, it will start with the multiplicative decrease. In the previous case, it start with the slow start phase, but here it will start with the multiplicative decrease phase. The congestion window size is equal to the threshold again, and the sender will start the congestion avoidance phase. So when my congestion window will reach to that of threshold value, then here it will start with the congestion avoidance phase. Now this is a summary of your TCP policy. Now see here, always it will start with slow start. So in that case, your congestion window is set to 1 and whenever it reaches to the threshold, and in this case, the threshold is nothing but how much number of packet you are sending or how much segment you are sending. It is a half of the maximum segment. For example, you have to send the 32 segments. So in that case, your threshold will be the 16. So whenever my window size is reached to the threshold, then it will start with the next phase, that is a congestion avoidance phase. In the congestion avoidance phase, again there are two cases, whether I'm getting the timeout or whether I'm getting the three acknowledgement. So when I'm getting the timeout, at that time it will set the window size is equal to 1. And it will set the threshold value, that is a half of the current congestion window size. And then it will start with the slow start phase. Whenever he got the three acknowledgement, here the window size is equal to that of threshold. And my threshold is nothing but half of the current congestion window size, and then it will again start with the congestion avoidance method. Now let us discuss one example. Now can you see here my threshold is 16. The threshold is 16 means how many segments the sender need to send, that is a 32 segments. So of course your first, your window size will set to 0. And then your slow start phase will on, and that is gradually increase your window size. And when it reach to this threshold, what will happen? It will move to the next step. Okay, that is nothing but congestion avoidance method, that is nothing but additive increase method. In the additive increase method, your window size will goes on increasing till timeout. And here the timeout is at the 20. Once it reached to the timeout, at that time your threshold value will reduce. It will be the half of the previous value. So now here your threshold value is set to the zero. And it moved to the multiplicative decrease method. And here once it reached to zero, then again it will move to the slow start phase. And your window sizes goes on increasing, and then it moves to the additive increase method that allow your window size to still increase. And when there is a 3 acknowledgement, at that time again it moves to the multiplicative decrease method, and then it will move to the additive increase method. Thank you.